Namrekanu. Abia, no more God's own state, but Miheti Hala Katu Market. The leader of the indigenous people of Biafra IPOB Namrekanu on Monday alleged that Abia State has changed from God's own state to Miheti Hala owned market. In a statement titled Finally, the reason why they initiated Operation Python Dance and proscription of IPOB become very clear, made available to newsmen through IPOB Media and Publicity Secretary Emma Powerful, Namrekanu also alleged that the more Miheti Hala terrorists kill the people of Abia and Southeast in general in their own land, the more the so-called governors are prepared to give to them more land. Namrekanu also blamed Ohanaeze Ndigbo for the alleged borrowing the people of Southeast are going through in the hands of the Miheti Hala terrorists pretending to be X-Men. Abia State from God's own state to Miheti Hala owned cattle market. Mind you, Lokpanta in the same Abia is now a full-fledged Fulani town. The more Miheti Hala terrorists kill us in our land, the more of it so-called governors are prepared to give to them. What a sick, sad joke when the history of Fulani terrorist conquest of Igboland is written in the next 100 years, it will be recalled that a certain group of men called Ohanaeze Ndigbo and a band of traitors working for the caliphate, sadly referred to as Igbo governors, plotted the Islamic takeover of the land of their ancestors. Apparently, all the Fulani terrorists did was to promise each Southeast state governor the same unrealizable slot of vice president of the Nigerian Republic. For this token promise, each governor is now falling over themselves to please the caliphate by ceding our ancestral lands to Fulani caliphate. These are the workers of iniquity some misguided people want us to regard as elders worthy of respect. Well, this is serious. Abia is no more God's own state but Miheti Hala's cattle market. Namrekanu blew hot this time around. But meanwhile, a lot of people have been of the opinion that why is it that these so-called Fulani have been allowed to dominate in the first place, and at the same time you people are complaining that these people are dominating your own town, and you should know that this is very risky. And now a lot of people have been of the opinion that who buy and eat this cow that these Fulani are selling? Because if you people really want them to leave, it's very simple, you should call for meeting. And you know yourselves, now don't buy from these people. Let the Igbos who have their own meat market, let them get what to buy, let them get it to sell on their own. As in, I think it will be a nice thing and it will be a very good development if the Igbos can say, okay, fine, okay, now we need to eat beef. Is very simple, and you don't want to involve the Hausas. You people can get your own meat seller. Yes, you can start selling your own meat. The Igbos can be selling and they buy from themselves. Then the punishment of the Fulani will be that you will not buy from them. It's as simple as that. This one will make them to even leave. Anything they are selling, you people, you have to discipline yourself because they are up to no good. Yes, and that is it. If it is tomatoes that they are selling, you people should get a tomato seller. The Igbos should be selling that same tomato. Then the Igbos should patronize the Igbos. You understand? If it is pepper, yes, let the Igbos also buy and sell to the Igbos.
and any other thing you believe that the Hausas are very good at selling. This is the time for the Igbos to start selling. Even if it is onion, you people should go to where you can get onion and start selling to them. And start selling to yourselves. As in, start selling to the Igbos. You people just have to be disciplined. Because these people now, before you know it, they will take over everywhere. And do you know the consequence of that? The consequence of that is death. Because these people, they have their reasons of coming down. Before you know it, they will start poisoning the food that they are selling to the Igbos. Because they know themselves, they might... See, the way I am just trying to calculate this thing, and I think it will be a very good thing for the Igbos to learn from this. Because this Fulani, before you know it, because now you don't want them to be in the land, yet they are coming to the land. Even the so-called governors and the likes of them are the ones selling, giving them space because of compensation or whatsoever. So this, you people have to be very disciplined, or else a lot of things will go wrong in the land. And I pray that God will continue to give us wisdom to be able to deal with this situation. And I think the important thing to do right now is to apply wisdom. Even the Bible says, where there is no wisdom, the people perish. Yes, people perish because of lack of wisdom. When the so-called Igbos, if they will be able to apply wisdom, I believe that a lot of things will go well. Now, you don't want these people to be in your land. And now that even the leaders of the Igbo community are being compensated to allow these people to take over some part of the state, to take over some part of the land in the country, in the eastern state, fine. All you don't have, you can't fight them. Yes, because these people are deadly. You can't fight them. But the only thing you can use to win them is wisdom. Just be diplomatic in this. We don't want these people to take over our land. What is it that they are good at that we need to get from them that will make us to say, let them stay? Anything you know that they have that will make you people to say, you can't do without them. You people should learn that trade. And in fact, I believe the Igbos can do exploits. And that is it. You can take over that and do better than them. So that these people will not take over this land. You people should fight for yourselves, and it will take you a long way. Because now a lot of things are happening, brutal killing of innocent souls now and then. By the time these people take over the land, what we are saying now is not what we'll be saying. Because these people are all to no good. We have said this times with that number. They are ready to kill and kill. Like the case of the other man that was in the farmland that... The other Fulani man was telling him that, why are you shouting at me? Is it because my cow eats some part of your crops? That's why you are shouting like this. If you want me to buy anything, if my cow has destroyed anything, something that I can replace, then you don't need to shout. And this one that you are shouting, this is the Hausa man, the Fulani man telling the Igbo man on his own plot of land, that this one that you are shouting now, if I kill you here now, what will happen? You can imagine that statement. As if human beings have now turned to mosquito, you can just kill them. And why is this statement coming up? Because they have been empowered. Because the Igbos have overlooked a lot of things. These Fulani now believe that they own the land, that they even own the life of these people, even in their home land. Can you go to the north? Can an Igbo man go to the north and be bragging and be giving orders? It doesn't work that way. You can't try it. But now it is happening here, and they are going scot-free. Because the so-called leaders are backing them up because of peanuts that has been given to them. which is very, very wrong. People are dying on a daily basis. People are being killed on a daily basis. Nothing is being done. Instead, if the Fulanis are being affected, maybe the Eastern person tries to offend the Fulani. The next thing, the governor will compensate the Fulani, will bribe them that they should not be angry. You can imagine all sorts. May the good Lord continue to protect us in Nigeria, in the Igbo land. Because this is getting out of hand. And that is it. Well, let me have your take on this. And remember to subscribe for more updates. Thanks and God bless.